first time I recognized that my grandma was somebody special and famous in 1967 when she had her first retrospective at the Whitney Museum in New York City.
By the time I met her, Louise Nevelson was a big thing.
We met at a restaurant and she glided in, you know, this butterfly. Didn't even seem as if she was taking steps. She just rolled in. Very spectacular. A woman, oh, I'd say close to 80 by that time. She was so loquacious and flirtatious almost. Louise was completely studied. She wore layers and layers of fabric.
She loved her furs. She was always wearing those furs all the time, year round. So that all, you know, was theatrical, but it was also much like her artwork. Her artwork is very layered and very textured, tactile. Black on black, white on white, gold on gold.
Take this salt.
The art scene in New York City was mostly dominated by men, and she had a terrible time being recognized. But she went on to say, you know, men come to me, and they say, oh, Louise, where have you been all our lives? And she said, I've been here all the time. Had a black station wagon that she rode around town inspecting dumpsters and stuff that people had thrown out in the street. Even if it was a toilet seat, she would take it.
These are beams from St. Mark's in the Bowery when it had a fire and somebody was trying to take them to the landfill and somebody said, why don't you take them to Louise Nevelson instead?
There were pieces of black rafter that were on white pedestals, and they became the central theme of her show at the Whitney Museum. There was very little that she would discard. As a matter of fact, if you look at some of those photographs that I did of her living room, she had, oh, a railroad spike or a big boat and not. All kinds of small things that she had picked up off the street, but she saw some beauty in this or something that might go together with something else she did.
Nevelson presents the photographer with the ultimate challenge because so much of her work was very interesting in articulated forms, but almost always monochromatic, all white, all black. The all black ones, especially if you had to show very much of the surround, were almost impossible to photograph because not only were they black, but they were matte black.
Well, you know, Louise almost had to make me start studying photography again because you don't do black on black without losing any form or any shape. I spent quite a bit of time finding out how to light the back panel and the middle panel and the front panel without destroying the piece of artwork.